How possible is this? What does this look like? What is a diet that does this?
How many people do you know that have done this?
So, I mean, I know we're going to get flamed, right? And there's going to be all the marketers in the world that are going to come to me and they're going to be like, Jason's wrong. But, if you can show me peer-reviewed studies that I'm wrong, I'll gladly admit that I am. But, you know, just simple science. To lose weight or to lose body fat, you need to be in a calorie deficit. To gain lean tissue, you need to be in a calorie surplus. I mean, physiology hasn't changed. The only exception that I really ever see to the rule is a really low training age. And I'll even tack on to that like a completely like off the wall training stimulus, so like a low training age in a new stimulus. So like somebody that is an experienced bodybuilder or they've done like hypertrophy style or, you know, global gym style training for quite some time, right? And all of a sudden they go to CrossFit. Like the volume completely changes, like the metabolic stimulus changes. Like I've actually seen some recomp there.
Well, they're getting the same benefits that we talk about a lot on the show, and the debate or the argument that I'd have with you is that where I think you're alluding to right now is kind of that those beginner lucky results that everybody kind of gets.
The like newbie gains.
Exactly, the newbie gains. You could be, if you come in, you've never really weight trained before in your life, and you come in the gym and your goal too is fat loss. So let's say your main goal, I want to lose 30 pounds of fat, but your method of doing so, you've listened to Mind Pump, you know that building muscle or lifting weights is the most ideal way. So you start lifting weights. What happens a lot of times, even in a caloric deficit, is because this person's never touched any weights, they also build a little bit of muscle along the way.
I think you have to have a really, really loud muscle building signal and a very, very responsive adaptation process at the same time. And so that usually happens with beginners with a lot of novelty, right? So new stimulus and or hormonal stimulus like anabolic steroids. Otherwise, it's really hard because building muscle is hard to begin with. Try building muscle while eating low enough calories to also lose body fat. It seems to be kind of competing.
So I don't want to use the word like optimized, but like like what you just described, I also think comes back to, I would say like for a client, having them at like a homeostatic balance or having them at homeostasis, right? And I think that when we look at this, when we look at fat loss, when we look at muscle building in general, so many people are already doing it from a compromised state, right? Like think of all the different things they've tried, like all the potential metabolic adaptations from the things that they've tried. So they've tried keto, they've tried carnivore, they've tried fasting, and they've gone like extreme calorie deficit, extreme calorie deficit, extreme calorie deficit. And now, even if they got on like an appropriate macro plan, they're so metabolically adapted, like they're not going to adapt the same way as somebody who has tried nothing, who has no hormonal issues, has no internal physiological issues, right? They're working closer from homeostatic balance, and therefore the results are going to happen faster. But, you know, to your point, Sal, like I was so hated on in the CrossFit world in the beginning before I got loved by the CrossFit world, right? But I was one of the ones that came in the beginning and I said, fuck paleo. And I was like, this is ridiculous that you guys think paleo is actually going to work long term in this extreme setting.
Or it's ideal, right?
Yeah.
Just because it works for some people doesn't necessarily mean
it didn't work. And that's the, like, so what Sal's saying is 100% true. Like people were seeing results despite what they were doing, not because of what they were doing. Mm-hmm. And so, like you said, when you go in the CrossFit gym, and the first time I went to a CrossFit gym, I had never barbell snatched. I had never clean and jerked, right? I'd never front squatted. Like I didn't even have the fucking mobility to get in a front rack. And so sure, perfect. Like, you know, 2.5-3 months in, I can front squat 400 pounds because I could back squat 500 at that time, right? So like ratio wise, it worked out. I could all of a sudden power clean, AKA reverse curl, you know, 255. Yeah. I could somehow heave 150 pounds over my head and try to, you know, overhead squat it. And those weren't because of anything I was doing nutrition wise or recovery wise or performance wise. That's just exposure to the movements. So when I used to give seminars, I would say you could achieve the same results in your first 8 to 9 months of CrossFit on paleo, on fasting, on keto, on high carb, on low carb. But I would also go so far as to say you could achieve the same results on 500 calories or 5,000 calories. And I always reference that as a neurological adaptation phase. You're just creating neurological adaptations. You're learning the movements, right? It's all brain. It's all connection in your brain. But at some point, you have to begin physically adapting. And when you start physically adapting, you require fuel and recovery. Like, you have to have the proper fuel substrates for the stimulus that you're providing to your body.
Well, when you're trying to add tissue, that requires a certain amount of energy.
Absolutely.
Now, I'll argue that neurological adaptations also require energy, but not nearly
exactly
to the same extent.
Yeah.
I don't think you
could go in with zero calories, but I think that your average on, I mean, we live in an obese world, right?
It's an
your average
analogy,
detrained person. I really see people that don't eat until dinner and they're like, I'm fucking PRing everything. And they would be like, it's gotta be paleo. Well, no, actually, you started eating whole foods, like you have less inflammation and you have exposure to new movements.
Yeah, you just started working out.
Exactly.
Yeah.